Hi Siddhis, welcome to another session of Social Science. In this session also, we are continuing with our Geography Chapter 3, Our Changing Earth. And in the first session of Geography Chapter 3, we discussed about the endogenic forces. And in this session, we are going to discuss about exogenic forces and that forces, how they are creating different landforms. And the landscape is formed by two processes, that are weathering and erosion. These are the endogenic forces that create different landforms. Weathering and erosion, that you have already learned. Weathering means breaking up of stones and other things into small particles, that are called the weathering. And erosion means, erosion is the removal of solids, the weathered material, from one place to another. That is called the erosion. And weathering and erosion are creating different landforms in our area. And first we are going to discuss about the weathering and the erosional activities of rivers. How rivers are forming different landforms. Here in this picture you can see the course of a river. Normally we can classify the river, course of a river, into three parts. That are upper course of the river, middle course, and one more is there, that is lower course of the river. From the mountains, the rivers are originating, and the originating portion is called upper course. What may be the landforms there? Waterfall will be there in the upper course of the river. And whenever the river is entering into plain area, it will take some twists and turns. There are also some landforms are there. Then in the ending portion, at the mouth of the river also, we have some landforms. So this is the middle course of the river. In this picture, you can see the big or deep turns and twists that the river is taking. Here also we have some landforms. Then this is the lower course of the river, and means the river is ending into an ocean or flowing out into an ocean or any other water bodies. So this is the lower course of the river, where there also we have one landform. Now let's move on to the details. So these are the features or landforms that are created by the river: waterfall, meanders, oxbow lake, flood plain, levees, and delta. So what is meant by waterfall? You all are familiar with waterfall. Water falling from a natural height is called a waterfall. A waterfall is a place where flowing water rapidly drops in elevation as it flows over a steep region or a cliff. From a high position, water is falling down. That type of landscapes are called a waterfall. Then coming to meanders, I told you, whenever the river is entering into the plain area, or in the middle course, the river enters the plain and it twists and turns, forming large bends known as meanders. Here in this picture, you can see that large bends or deep bends by the river. These bends are called the meanders. And what happening is, meantime, this U-shaped body of water is cut down from the mainstream of river, and that type of lakes are called the oxbow lake because of that shape. The like oxbow like shape is there, that's why it is called the oxbow lakes. So how oxbow lakes are formed? The deep bends of the river or the U-shaped water body will be cut down from the main stream of the river and will form a lake. That type of lakes are called the oxbow lake. So, and an oxbow lake is a U-shaped body of water formed when a wide meander from the main stream of the river is cut off to create a lake. These meanders are, wide meander will be cut off from the main stream, and that type of lakes are called an oxbow lake. And next is floodplain. When the river overflows its banks, it leads to the flooding of the neighboring areas. When the river is overflowing, what will happen? It will deposit something in the seashores, and that will lead to the formation of floodplains. As it floods, as the river floods, it deposits layers of fine soil and other material called sediments along its banks. These led to the formation of floodplains. The next is levees. The raised banks of the rivers are called levees. Now, next landform is delta. A delta is a landform that is created at the end of the river or mouth of the river. What is happening is, at the lower course of the river, the speed of the river or speed of the water will be slowed down and it will be depositing all the eroded materials at the mouth of the river, and it will create a landform called a delta. Here in this picture, it is clear that this is the end of the river or mouth of the river. After this, the river is ending. So here, this is called a delta. And now, let's watch a video that will help you to understand more about the work of river.
The course of a river comprises of three distinct parts. First is the upper or the mountain course where the river originates. Here, the velocity of the water is faster due to the steep gradient. The floor of the valley is narrow and the valleys are V-shaped. Second is the middle or the valley course, where floors are wider and the sides of the valley are more gently sloping. Here, the velocity of the river is slower than the upper stage. Meanders are typical landforms found in this stage of the river. The third part of the river is the lower course, which has a gentle slope and is almost flat. The river channel is usually at its widest and deepest here, because the amount of water flowing within the river is at its greatest. Oxbow lakes are conspicuous features in the lower course of a river apart from the deltas where the river drains into seas. Now, we will discuss about what are meanders and how are they formed. Meanders are formed in the middle course of a river. The rivers flow through almost a flat plain in the middle courses. As water flowing under gravity seldom flows straight for any long distance, a winding course soon develops. The irregularities of the ground force the river to swing in great S-shaped curves, forming horseshoe-like loops called meanders. Now let us see how a meander forms. The water in a river channel flows faster round the outside bend of a river due to centrifugal force, whereas it is relatively slow on the inside bends. The fast flowing water on the outside bend erodes the river bank, whereas slow moving water deposits sand and mud on the inside bend. At the site of erosion on the outside bend, a steep river cliff is created. The water piles up on the outside bend due to centrifugal force. A bottom current is set up in a corkscrew motion, which deposits the eroded material on the inner bank, forming a slip-off slope. In the lower course of a river, a meander becomes very much pronounced. The outside bend gets eroded rapidly and the meander loop becomes almost a complete circle. Gradually, the narrow necks of the loop erode further and intersect each other. Now, the river cuts through the intersection to flow in a straight path. As a result, the meander loop is abandoned and it forms an oxbow lake. The oxbow lake later turns into a swamp and subsequent floods may silt up the lake. It becomes marshy and eventually dries up.
So, in this session, what all topics we covered? Work of rivers like waterfall, meanders, oxbow lake, floodplain, levees, and delta. Hope you all understand this session. Thank you.